Okay. Hello, hello. Good morning, everybody. Take a big breath in. Exhale. Everybody take another breath for me. Exhale. Just let's go zen for a little minute. Hey, it is so nice to see you on a Friday morning. We're so glad that you made it. We've kind of been waiting for one other school, and we're just going to go ahead and start. So if they come, don't worry about it. They've got plenty of seats to choose from. Yes? If some of you wanted to move into center, you are able to do that because you have some room. If you're happy where you're at, that's fine. Yes? Yes? Okay. I just would like you to think about all that it takes to go into a show other than dancers. Like your teachers who brought you here, maybe some applause for them, and your chaperones that helped out. I want you to turn around behind you and see the marvelous Dr. Phillips High School stream team who's here streaming and recording the show. Give them a hand. And we've got all of our tech crew who are up in the booth. These are students who are running the lights and the music and backstage. These are students who are teching the show to keep it flowing and keep it going. So it's more than just dance that goes into any concert, as all of you know, and we want to celebrate all that it takes to make this happen. What you are going to see is from our Elements of Dance. This concert is tomorrow night, full length. We have some guest pieces that are just not here for today. These are Dr. Phillips students. So you're going to see our company dancers from the high school. You'll see our level 2, 3, and 4. And you're going to see our brand new elective program that we started this year. So we're super excited. And everybody's doing ballet, jazz, and modern. Everybody's doing all kinds of stuff. So we have all kinds of different things for you to see. If you love something, clap for it. If you really love something, stand up and applaud at the end. Yes? But what we're not going to do, what we're not going to do is take out phones and videotape, because that's against copyright laws. And I hope that we all understand we run a professional program here. You don't do it when you go to the Dr. Phillips Performing Arts Center. You don't do it here. Got it? That goes for all my friends and chaperones. We will make sure that we have opportunity for pictures at the end, but we don't take video. Got it? All right, thanks for being professional. So I hope that you enjoy, first of all, can we celebrate Wendy Ridge for being here? Give a big shout out, yes. And we've got Legacy Middle School, Legacy. Yeah. Oh, I think you can make a little louder noise than that. We got Maxie Elementary that made it in. And I know we have Lockhart. I saw Lockhart make it here. And Wolf Lake will be joining us a little bit later, but we can give them a play. Yeah? So let's get started. This piece is called Binary. I'm going to ask my tech crew to let me get down safely and to the back before we start. Yes? Thanks. Let's have some fun. Thank you, ladies. And now we have No, No, No Way. Next, we have to the stage, Bites. Thank you. Now to the stage, we have a senior piece, Harmony of Mind, Body, Spirit.
Thank you, seniors. All right, let's change up the mood a little bit with Gimme the Disco. Thank you, dancers. And now we bring to the stage Charmant, which is French for charming.
Thank you.
Thank you, Midnight Blues. And next we have Make 'em Laugh.
Sempre foi o meu céu, meu sol.
No. Yeah. Hey. All right. So that brings us to intermission. And this brings us to time for you to get a chance to ask some questions or what is it that we want to know? I'm back here. I'm making my way. All right. So what do you have? Your thoughts, your questions. What do you have? You have to run to me because I'm not running so fast these days. What do you think? Yeah? How are we doing? Question.
How long are the rehearsals?
How long are the rehearsals? Do you mean when we're in show week? So when we're in show week, we load the Marley in on Tuesday afternoon. And then on Wednesday, we come into Balak. And then Wednesday night, we have a tech rehearsal till 8 o'clock, and then Thursday, a tech till 8 o'clock, and then we do the in-schools here on Friday. They were here this morning. They already had a class to warm up and get ready and then go through some blocking for any issues that we have. So is that good? Are there other questions? You all come to me. This is where I am. You can come and find me. and I'll make my way slowly, slowly. If you have a question, you run over to me, because you'll be faster than I am right now.
What was the meaning of the second dance?
What was the second dance? Yeah, what was the second dance? I don't have it memorized.
It was the one before.
Bayou Boogie. It was just some fun. No deep meaning. You get to take whatever meaning you want. Some things don't mean anything sometimes.
I thought it was amazing.
Well, that is fabulous to hear. The dancers always like to hear applause, don't they? Walk and talk. What's your question?
What is the audition process like for the magnet program?
The audition process for the magnet program actually started in February.
What is it like?
Okay, so the students do a warm-up class that's not adjudicated with the seniors. Then they come into a professional panel and they do short little ballet etudes, very short phrases. Then they do short modern phrases. Then they do an improv. Then they do solos. And then we say goodbye. Yeah. Question.
Do you know all their names?
I do. I do know all their names. Yes. Well, that would take 50. So that would, yeah. Well, no, 50 people. But I'll bring them out at the end and we'll do all their, I'll let them say all their names. Is that fair? Because if I say it right now, you won't match the name to the person, you haven't seen them. Yeah. So there's 50 dancers in the show. Yeah, I know.
What do you think your favorite dance would be?
All of them. People always ask, and I think this is very interesting, what is your favorite style or what's your favorite genre? And I say to you, all of them. I do not like being in a box. I do not like being told that only this matters. I like all dance, I like all movement, and I want my dancers to like all dance and all movement. If you want to come and ask a question, you can see where I am, run to me and ask. Yes? Yes? Thoughts, ideas, concerns, what makes you think? What makes you think different? Yeah? Run to me, run to me. You see right where I'm at. Run, 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 run.
Who choreographed the dances?
Well, there are a lot of people who choreograph the dances for this show. That some of it is faculty, which is me. Some of it is guesswork. And for our elective program, I have 3 student teachers, so they choreographed, and I have 2 student teachers in that teach. So we have 5 student pieces in the show, and a lot of mine and a lot of guests. Yes?
What made you come up with the choreography for Make Them Laugh?
I'm so glad you asked that, and that was mine. How did you even know? So here's what happened. I actually have a student who's not here today, but he'll be in the show tomorrow night. And he brought me, he's an elective student, and he brought me this big box when we came back from Christmas. He said, I found this and I just wanted to donate it. And inside the box was clown stuff. And inside the box was a bunch of red noses. And I'm thinking, what can I do with a clown? I don't know, should I give this to theater? And then when those noses came out, there were 2 magnet dancers with me. And I'm like, are those red noses? And they're like, yes. And I'm like, I must have one. And I put it on, I'm like, oh my God, I should just do a piece. Well, the 2 of them started laughing, and they're like, yes, and we want level 4 to have this piece. I'm like, fine, I will make a piece, and I'll call it Make 'em Laugh. You do? Well, that's good, because can't we laugh? Isn't dance supposed to be fun sometimes? It doesn't always have to be angsty. Lord, have mercy on my soul. We have enough angst. Enough angst. Sometimes we're allowed to laugh.
What type of style was Make It Laugh?
Did you see any one style in Make 'em Laugh? Oh, that's what we call a fusion. You gotta know some ballet, you gotta know some jazz, you better know some modern. And you better be ready to circus it up. Yeah? Everything goes.
Is it hard to balance school and dance?
Is it hard to balance school and dance? I think all the kids would say yes. And I think every teacher would say yes. but we do it anyway because we love it. And some of us, we have to. Like, I would like to do a very simple job that then I was done. Or would I? Because then it would be boring, and I just really can't stand boring.
Do they have team names?
Team names? They have classes. We have the Dance in Motion Company. But I don't, you know, we're the Dr. Phillips High School Panthers, but we don't really, you know, I don't know. Like, we're not superstars. We're all for one and one for all. Yeah, I like that, though.
What is the main type of dance you guys do?
All of them. There is no one type. We do study technically in class. Ballet is Monday and Thursday, so that could be point or flat shoes. Tuesday is modern. Wednesday is what we call our health day, so it could be yoga practices, Pilates, health-related, stress relaxation. It could be rehearsal if we need it. Sometimes we need it. Friday is jazz. We have a RISE program. Have you all been doing RISE or REACH or something with Orlando Ballet? And so we even have, Gina, can you stand up in the back and wave to us? Actually, Gina Hatch is our RISE instructor from Orlando Ballet. And the last piece you see is hers. Jelly's Last Dance will be Gina's piece that we're doing for RISE. So, fun, everything. Did I answer your question? Oh.
What do you recommend to do when things collide?
When things collide, as in I crash into another dancer, or when I have a bad day?
When you have one event and you have another event at the same
time. Oh, when we have two events at the same time, which happens to us all the time, then you have to choose. Because can you be in two places at one time? Me either, and I've tried. So I've tried for 38 years, and it hasn't worked out so good. Yeah, so you have to choose, and that's why it's important to know.
Stressful while like making all the dances?
Absolutely, absolutely stressful. Yes, it always is. But let me tell you a secret. How do you deal with stress? How do you deal with stress? And that's kind of mindset. How do you get over things and move on? Make them laugh. How long did we spend?
I don't know. A week?
2 days, pretty much. Maybe three, and that's all they had, because that's all the time we had together to do it. So it's you have to learn how to move quick and understand, and what we do is we call it calling in the plays. Here's the outline, boom, boom, I'm going to give you notes, now I want you to develop this. I need this now. By the time it goes tomorrow night, we'll have and more things. I already have more notes. Thanks. Next question.
Do they have to skip class to go to learn the dance?
No, we do it in our class or in our rehearsal. But they are not in class today for a field trip, so they can be here with you. Mm-hmm.
How did you come up with a Brazilian song for the dance? How did you become, like, how did you, like, get a Brazilian song for the dance?
How do I get a bazillion songs for the dance? Oh, Brazilian. I don't get all of the music, first of all. That's why we have some are mine, some are guests, some are students. So all of us search differently for different music and pull it in. Yeah.
What made you pursue dance?
You know, that is a great question. And here's what my mom and my dad said to me. I was dancing out of the womb. Literally, I guess from the time that I just could walk and move, I was just dancing all around. So I was that kid who danced really early. I'm the weird one that I would do a lot of things on my own. My brain, when I hear music, always saw movement. So I don't think sometimes that you choose something. Sometimes I think you get chosen for. And so for me, it was just always, this was my world, always. Does that make sense? Some of us find it late. A lot of my guys, I'm so sad you can't see him today, but he'll be here tomorrow. Never danced, he's done flags, but never danced until class this year. And sometimes we find out late this is something where our passion lies. And that's fine, it doesn't matter. Most of the guys really that we know actually find that they love dance so much, sometimes high school or college. So it's never too late. I love that question, that was a great one. Do we have time for one more, tech crew? Can you guys keep me on target? I like your dress, look how cute she is.
Thank you. Why did you guys wear a mask, like one here and one?
Well, I'm not the choreographer for that piece. That piece was binary. Why did we do that? I think just to try something weird and different. Wasn't that eerie? And the costumes on purpose, she wanted to play with the idea of, could you tell if somebody was facing the front or the back? So that was just, it was just a play. You know, let's see what happens with it. And it's kind of weird. The first time they did that line and they did this slow look, I was in the studio, I'm like, ooh, that is weird. It's just weird. Isn't that weird? But it's kind of, I don't know, fun to do something really different. You'll think of that piece again, won't you? But no nightmares. No nightmares. How are we doing on time? Where are we at? Sure. Do we have any other questions? Run.
Do you prefer choreographing songs with or without words?
That's a very good question, and I love this. When I personally like usually no lyrics, but you're like, wait a minute, but you had lyrics at the end right here. Yeah, sometimes we want lyrics. In the fall, I had a piece that was Building Rainbows that I deliberately choreographed to lyrics. But most of the time, I like without, and here's why. Because now, I can do anything I want. But if I hear words fly to the sky, I gotta do something up in the air. But what if I wanted to do something down on the ground? I can't do it. Yeah, that was a great question. But there's a time and a place for everything. Any others? Since I guess there's a long bathroom break, we'll try for a couple more questions. And what I'll do at the end when we're done is I'll bring everybody out so you can meet them and we can have some pictures all together. Run.
What were your dancers like in hip hop?
Say that one more time.
What were your dancers like in hip hop?
Oh, they can hip hop, these kids can do. We just don't have a piece for hip hop right now, this show. But yeah, again, we want to be able to do everything and do it well. Yeah.
How long does it take to put together a showcase?
So, probably for this show, some things we started like the end of January, and most of it mid-February, okay? So, about a month to 6 weeks is about all we're gonna do. Yeah, good questions.
What's one of your favorite dance moves?
Say that again?
What's one of your favorite dance moves?
Could you all hear her? What's one of your favorite dance moves? And you know the answer already. All of them. Come. Who's got their question?
How long did it take you to make each individual dance?
Well, that's different. Some dances, it took longer, and then some, it's just we throw it out there very fast. So the piece you saw, we probably had 3 days, and then other pieces, maybe they needed 3 weeks. Mm-hmm.
How did you come up with the songs?
So the songs, again, are all different. And people might hear music and say, oh my God, this is interesting. Or exactly, if you have a theme first, then you search for music that you want. So I knew I wanted certain music for Make 'Em Laugh, and then I had to do a search because I didn't want it to be all the same. I absolutely wanted it to make sure that you had the circusy thing and then there was something sad and how are we gonna make her happy, and that was the reason to make them laugh. So you just have to kind of build out what you want and then do a search for music that works for what you want. Yeah, I like that. Okay.
How do they change so fast?
Well, they didn't do it so well last night, so they had to come here, and the tech crew put them on the timer and said, let's give it a go. So sometimes we have to practice our quick changes. Yeah.
I have two questions. The first one is, how long have you been doing dance for? How long have you been doing dance for?
How long have I been dancing? Well, that's going to be 61 years there. Yeah, that's a long time. That's why I guess this right now.
And then my other question is, how long is the rehearsal?
How long is the rehearsal? I answered that already. We, you know, it's different all the time. Show week, we're here till 8 o'clock, okay? But most of the time, they just do a quick in-class, and then the company, they have 2 days for 2 hours. Yeah, okay, run.
What is your favorite dance when you...
This is the last question.
What was your favorite dance when you were a child?
You're not going to believe this. All of it. I know you're shocked. I know you can't believe me. Didn't matter. If there was moving, I was happy. Yeah. All right. Here we go. We're back to our seats. And we are going to start. This next piece is actually from a production that we're doing with Orlando Ballet. And this was through the choreographer, Natria Blake, who has won many awards. And she has given us permission. She's actually premiering her full length as we speak tonight and tomorrow. But she came to us for the first time on Tuesday, loved it so much. She's like, those DP dancers, they can do breakthrough anytime. So you all, I would like you to welcome a new emerging choreographer with her piece, Breakthrough.
Para, 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 para
All right, thank you, dancers. Next, we welcome to the stage, Hush.
Diamond ring is brass. Papa gonna buy you a looking glass. And if that looking glass will ring, Papa gonna buy you a chocolate cake.
Let's man.
That puppy won't bark, Papa's gonna buy you a horse and cart. And if that horse and cart break down, Papa's gonna buy you a big toy clown. Hush, little baby, don't you cry. Mama's gonna sing you a lullaby. Yahoo! Get back.
And now we have Bellissima. Thank you, ladies. And next to the stage, we're going to bring our men with Sharp Dressed.
Thank you.
Thank you, guys. Next up, we have Grandma's Hands. Next, we welcome to the stage Wild, Wild Waltz. And now we have another level three senior piece, Luca. Okay, thank you, dancers. Quick change time. So you get the inside scoop. Typically, we would have a guest piece, but I'm going to talk for 2 minutes and 40 seconds and no longer than that. But if you have a question, you can ask. Run to me if you're a sprinter, if you had a final question. Any thoughts? Something you wanted to know about? Before we do our last piece, I will tell you the marvelous Gina Hatch that you met a little bit earlier is our Orlando Ballet. So she came in for us and we did everybody, all the magnet, all the elective, everybody had the chance to be in this next piece. So it's a lot of fun. And this is a swing piece. So it's totally different. I don't know where you all are going for 2 minutes. I hope you're fast because we're starting with or without you. Almost, but not quite. Yes. Okay. Any final thoughts? Any final questions? Any wonderings? Any observations? Any, I wanted to know this? Run! Because you see where I'm at. Fast, fast. I think we're only at a minute 40 left.
Do you like dancing?
Hello. By now, we should know the answer to that question, everybody. Yes, I can't live without it. Next.
How are you feeling?
How am I feeling? A little chilly. I've got about 4 layers on right now. Yeah, next.
What is the style most used in this whole show?
It's pretty split. Ballet, modern jazz, ballet, modern jazz, ballet, modern jazz, ballet, modern jazz, fusion, 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 fusion.
How do you prepare before dances?
We warm up. We took a ballet class this morning for an hour. Yeah, had some personal yoga time, stretch time, and then blocked. Yep.
What do you do if, like, you get stuck and don't know what to choreograph?
I go to sleep. Go to sleep.
How, like, the male dancers?
The men?
Yes, the men. Like, what was the idea for that?
First of all, who doesn't love ZZ Top, Sharp Dressed Man? I know that probably some of you are like, who is that? Sorry, old school is kind of fun. And when you've got 3 guys, usually you only have 1. But to have 3, oh my God, you gotta have a piece, Sharp Dressed Man.
In my class, we only have like 1 male dancer.
I know, why is that? Why do we only see 1? Where's the courage of these young men? Honestly, isn't it fun to see males up on stage all together? Come on, isn't that fun? Yes! Everybody dances, everybody dances. I will tell you a secret. If you're a guy and you're dancing, the world is your stage. Mm-hmm. Are we ready? All right, let's bring it home with Jelly's Last Dance. Here we go!
Thank you.
All right, my friends, dancers, if you could run around to the downstage of the main, that would be great. See if they remember. And then I'll have them say a quick hello. Everybody run out, run out, run out, run out, run out. Run, 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 run. Yes. Make sure we get everybody. All right, super fast. Here's what we're going to do. We're going to say our name and our age really, really fast. I'm going to come behind you. Really. Ready? Go.
My name is Ariagna, and I'm a senior.
My name is Valeria, and I'm a sophomore.
My name is Aiden, and I'm a junior.
My name is Grace, and I'm a junior.
My name is Reese, and I'm a junior.
My name is Bella, and I'm a junior.
My name is Jazzy, and I'm a senior.
My name is Kaori, and I'm a sophomore.
My name is Madison, and I'm a freshman.
And she
has passion.
Inside joke.
My name is Kendall, and I'm a junior.
My name is Noor, and I'm a freshman.
My name is Livy, I'm a sophomore.
My name is Piper, I'm a freshman.
My name is Andre, and I'm a freshman.
My name is Dakota, and I'm a senior.
My name's Linton, and I'm a senior.
Oh, I'm Alex, and I'm a senior.
My name's Avery, and I'm a freshman.
My name is Daria, and I'm a freshman.
She almost said senior. I heard that. You heard that, right?
My name's Hannah, and I'm a junior.
My name is Paris, and I'm a sophomore.
My name is Asana, and I'm a freshman.
My name's Michaela, and I'm a junior.
Sorry. Oh, I'm Katie. I'm a sophomore.
My name's Charisma, and I'm a freshman.
My name is Maddie, and I'm a junior.
My name is Olivia, and I'm a freshman.
And I'm Nadia, I'm a senior.
And there they are. Woo! I don't know why you're tripping. You better get on the stage so they don't fall. And electives, I guess they're shy. I guess they didn't come out, but we have like, well, where are you? Come out and say hi. There they are. There they are. We've got a few more back there. Come say hello, everybody.
Hi, I'm Charlotte. I'm a senior.
Hi, I'm Heaven. I'm a sophomore. Come
to me. Hi, I'm Paige, and I'm a junior.
Hi, my name is Bruce. I'm a freshman.
Hi, my name is Tiana. I'm a senior.
Okay, so they're here. If you have any questions that you wanted before you have to go, you've got like a couple. If you want pictures, that can come, girls and guys. Can we make a big thing if you want to come up to the apron and have pictures with your teacher and your friends? Levels, 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 levels. Hey, did you have fun? Good. All right. Available for pictures.